Hello everyone, so today we're going to be doing planet battles. I'm thinking I'll make four different planets with kind of four different biomes, I guess you could say, different kind of resources, different access to different things, and we'll see who does the best. So we're going to start off with a huge world, I think, and I'm just going to say that the mountains are space. So I'm going to cover the whole world in mountains, and I guess we got to kill all these little boys. There are no space flies. Get out of here. So my thoughts here are we're going to do Earth kind of in this corner, then we're going to do Mars, then we're going to do Uranus in the bottom left, and then we're going to do Neptune, I think. Let me see. Mercury. We're going to do Mercury down here. So my thoughts are each one's going to be kind of a different biome. I'm going to make them have kind of advantages and disadvantages, and we'll see kind of who does the best. So start off with Earth over here. So Earth is going to be kind of just water and forest mostly. So I'm going to make a nice circle for Earth, and I'm not gonna be able to draw a perfect circle. I mean, it's pretty good, you know, not gonna lie. We'll put some rain in here. So like I said, Earth is going to be water and forest mostly with cool. So Earth's just going to be like a few different islands, it looks like. Rain some seeds down on there. And then Earth is going to have actually a decent amount of ore. So I think Earth will give them some stone and some ore deposit. The downside to Earth is that they have less land space, but they're going to have access to all the resources, basically. So they're kind of the vanilla, I guess. They don't have any advantages, but they don't have any disadvantages, you know? Okay, so that's good. And then we'll give them some fruit bushes. There we go. Yeah, so that looks pretty good. Next is Mars. So we'll put Mars over here in this corner. Trying to draw a circle. Come on. That's an oval. It has to be a circle. So the benefit of Mars, I think, is going to be the fact that they have so much lumber, I guess, you know, so they can build a lot. But where they're gonna be lacking is food, I think. So I'm gonna give them like a few little patches of fruit bushes, but that's about all they're gonna get. They have plenty of lumber, and they're going to have just a few ore deposits. Okay, so that looks good. And then down here we'll make Uranus. So that one is going to be mostly soil. So they're going to have access to basically more food than all the other places, but they're going to have a low amount of lumber, I think. Shoot, no. Okay, put that back. Go away. Okay, so we will make it rain over there. Cool, and then we'll give them some little patches of forest. Obviously, I want them to build a little bit at least. So we'll give them three little patches of forest and rain on those. There you go. Cool, and then I was going to give them, they're going to have like a medium amount of ore, I think. So we'll give them three stone, a couple irons, and a couple golds. And then fourthly, we're going to make Mercury, which Mercury, I think, is going to be kind of the ore planet. So they're not going to have a lot of everything else, but they're going to have a ton of ores. And then I'm actually going to put some like mountains in here, I think. I'm going to move this up a little bit, actually. That's good enough. I'm cool with them being a little bit bigger. We're going to put some hills down on Mercury. It's going to be both the worst and best planet, I think. Because I'm thinking we'll put some hills, and we'll probably put some volcanoes and different things. I don't really like how this one looks, I'm going to be honest here. Let's erase some of that. Why did I draw them like this? Why do they look like that? So like I said, it's going to be both the best and the worst planet, because they're going to have, I'm going to give them a ton of resources. They'll have access to, obviously, to lumber, because the sand just naturally grows cactuses. We'll give them a few little patches of fruit bushes here. That'll be good. Yeah, cool. So those are all done. And then I was thinking I would put one planet actually in the middle. And we'll make this just a straight forest planet. But I'm thinking that we'll have one planet in the middle. And then at some point, maybe in 100 years or so, we'll move them all to the middle planet. And they'll have to fight over just the middle planet. And we'll see who wins that. I'm going to go ahead and create. This will just be a straight like forest planet, I think. Yeah, so we'll make the biggest planet kind of in the middle. And this is just going to be straight just heaven. This will be the best planet. It's going to be just lush green forest. Maybe we'll put some rivers in there. Yeah, let's put some rivers in there. I just want to make this like the best planet possible. Put some kind of some rivers running through. There we go. And there'll be plenty of resources, plenty of stone, ore, and gold. And then we'll put put some water in there and some fruit bushes. See, doesn't that just look wonderful? Well, now I think that we are ready to start doing stuff. So I'm gonna get my auto clicker all set up here. Okay, so top left, obviously humans. We'll put humans up here. I think I'll just spawn 100 of them, or 110 humans, I guess. We'll do 110 everywhere. And then this is Mars over here, so obviously I'm gonna put orcs over here because they kind of look like Martians, I guess. They're green. I don't know. So we need to make sure there's 220. Okay, and then we'll put dwarves down here. Obviously, it's kind of a more of a rocky planet, so we need 330. Oh, darn it, I spawned too many again. And then we'll put elves down here. I'm not gonna mess this up. We need 450 around. All right, so we'll let them do their thing. Let's look at the world laws, make sure. Diplomacy doesn't really matter right now. We'll turn it off anyways. Hunger, yeah, I want hunger on. Grass, kingdom expansion. We'll get rid of rebellions for now. Old age, yeah. Okay, I think that looks good. Yeah, usually I've turned off hunger for like every time I filmed the video, but this time I'm kind of like, you know, I want to see how the different biomes react to having limited amounts of food. Oh, and I want to actually rename kingdoms. This will be Earth. Okay, where's a citizen of this village? I was gonna say, I hope they don't all form different villages, but that's exactly what they did. Oh, looks like everyone's doing that. And then this looks like the biggest place over here, so we'll rename that. What is this? Mercury. And then we got, what's the biggest village here? Donor. And then this is Uranus. See what happens. So I'm thinking maybe we'll do like year 150, and then we'll move them all over here. And I think I'm actually going to send all these planets into civil wars. I know it's a little bit unfair because of the humans. Won't have to do that, but I need them all to be on the same side, you know? So let's go ahead and spite them real quick. I'm sorry, everyone. Hopefully this will get resolved pretty quickly. Turquoise seems to be doing the best, so hopefully turquoise will take over everything. Yeah, this might actually be fine. I don't think they're really losing anyone. No, come on. Almost there. Don't worry, you'll get them next time. Looks like all of dwarves is all united now. And it looks like orcs as well. Okay, that actually turned out a lot better than I thought it would. I don't think they lost like about any population. I just can't take this city of 6 people. It's so easy. There's like one little kid over here. Oh, they're scared of this guy over here. Where are you? Let me click on you. Yeah, this is why they're not going over there. I got this giant ass guy guarding the town. But he's just over here threatening everyone. It's like, you better not come into my town. Okay, there we go. Cool, so now we can take a look at the kingdoms and see how they're all doing. Okay, so you got dwarves up here. Dwarves are by far doing the best. Oh my lord. Look, they got 283 population. The biggest army with 136. 4 major cities, 77 houses. And then orcs. I guess orcs aren't too far behind. 245, 119 army, which is surprising. I'm surprised that the dwarves actually have a bigger army. And then you got elves and humans down here just being dum-dums. What year are we at? Maybe we'll go to, let's go to year 200, actually. I want to give them a little more time to develop so that they can do their thing, but it might just end up coming down to orcs and dwarves. It seems like humans and elves have like a fourth of the army, which is probably just due to their resources, I would think. Yeah, because I think that, okay, no, they still have iron and stone. I was going to say maybe they used up all their resources, but I think that just not having the trees, the lumber they need, has been kind of a disadvantage for them. But humans don't really have an excuse because they have basically everything. I think it's just the population cap that's been the problem, because they don't have as much land as any of the other civilizations. Let's view kind of the village and see how they're doing. Villages. Yeah, so they definitely are, they're lacking in the amount of space they need. But it looks like they're doing good in every other aspect. They got gems. I don't know where they got gems from. They got bones. Ore. They seem to be doing pretty well. Doesn't seem like anyone's starving yet. These people over here, let's check how they're doing. You got a kid over here with a bloodlust. That's probably not good. Yeah, they seem to be doing good on resources. Village age 90. Let's see how everyone's hunger's doing. Are you guys dying of hunger? They're doing pretty well for themselves. They're actually making farms and stuff, but they definitely were lacking in the food department. And these guys over here, let's see how they're doing. Are they Are they dying of hunger? No. Look at that. He's a fat guy. Fatty's over there devouring all the food when this guy's starving. Dang, these guys are just bloodthirsty. They're like, please let us out. I want to go kill. Let's check on Uranus City. Their city over here. And this is just this one little city, so it's fine if they don't have all the stuff. Seem to be doing well, though. They've got a ton of bread just from that little farm there. They've gotten almost 700 bread now and a ton of wheat to make more bread. They're making cider. Ooh. They're just over here vibing on Elf Planet. Yeah, I think humans are definitely at the big disadvantage here. They have the nicest planet, though. I will say that. This is, out of all these, this is definitely the one I would like to live on, which I guess it is Earth. I already live there, but still. I'm going to go ahead and just fast forward to year 200, and we'll see what happens. All right, so we're just short of year 200. Let's see what our top contenders are. Okay, humans in the last 100 years don't seem to have done anything. So, yeah, good luck to them. But it looks like elves have actually caught up a little bit, so they might actually have a fighting chance here. All right, so we've just reached year 200. So I have to kind of figure out how exactly I'm going to do this. First, I'm going to build some bridges to the middle planet here. Because they need to kind of bridge all their islands so they can actually get out. Okay, cool. It looks like people are actually going down there. I need to figure out a way to kind of force them down there. I'm not sure. I can try the magnet. I think once they're all established here, I can start moving people. Here, I'm actually going to save this real quick because I want to make sure this actually works and go back if it doesn't. So I think I'm actually going to cover all these planets in mountains. Hopefully it doesn't kill everyone. And I think since they have civilizations already in there, I think that we could just move them. Why isn't it grabbing these guys? I want to grab you. Okay, for some reason it doesn't let me grab everyone. Must be just a glitch. So we can move everyone to the center. Shoot, it actually worked. I did not think that would work. Then we can cover up these little dumb little bridges. Dang, that's actually cool. That's a good thing to know for future stuff I do. And then you got all these guys just dying out here. Should have let me pick you up. All right, so now they're going to kill each other. I'm going to spite them and then we'll see who wins. Alright, so it looks like dwarves are already kind of going at it with the orcs here. It looks like the humans are going at war with the elves and orcs with the dwarves, which is good because I feel like both of those teams are on the same kind of level. Yeah, dang, look at that. Huge army over there. Seems like the orcs don't have much armor. It looks like they just have like clubs and stuff, whereas the dwarves are actually pretty like fitted with some nice armor. Oh, and there goes humans. There's like one guy. Oh no. Oh, that feels bad. There's just like one little kid. Mommy, I'm scared. It was funny that even the wolf was chasing him. Looks like the orcs actually got wiped out. It's funny that they're not attacking this guy. This guy's just chilling here. I think I'm gonna construct some little land bridges just to make it easier. Okay, so it comes down to really just the orcs and I always accidentally call them orcs. The dwarves and the elves here. Oh shoot. Dwarves lost a ton of their army in that whole little thing, so the elves might actually have a chance. Okay, it looks like the elves are actually moving in on the dwarves right now. Got a little army here. Come on, guys, kill each other. Let's go sonic speed for a little bit. Oh, this is a little bit of a scuffle. Okay, dwarves are definitely losing population pretty fast. Oh, so are elves. All right, let's slow this down. It looks like they're dying of hunger. Did you see that? It might be. Yeah, they're dying of hunger right now. Yeah, it looks like the dwarves are finishing them off. They've got like this little civilization right here. Come on, man, go attack him. Oh, there's one guy left. Yeah, let's see if we can find him. Ah, there he is. It's like, where's Waldo? Oh, is this that bloodlusty kid I was looking at earlier? They might have a problem with him. Dang, he's pretty loaded up. Let's go ahead and let's bless him. Oh. Oh, rip. Well, that was a little less climactic than I thought it would be. All right, so dwarves have officially pulled this off. It got pretty close. I think that the dwarves, just because they had access to so much, or they were able to really kind of fit their army with kind of the best stuff. Anyways, I guess that concludes the video. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you tomorrow. Bye.